right. My name's Hannah Wisniewski. I teach 11th grade American Studies here at the high school.
I usually call her Wiz, short for Miss Wisniewski.
No pun intended, she's a real whiz with history. She definitely knows her stuff.
She could say something like, I don't even remember what that means. And it's just, you know, 5 minutes of explaining. And it's great because, you know, it's a personal history lesson.
Obviously, she has a great interest in social studies and history and worked at Beverly Hills for many years. And I think was really thrilled to be able to come up here, work with our social studies department, and now is doing American history, which is my kids always thought was the best course that they ever had.
So coming to the high school and teaching American studies was awesome, because it's not so much military history, it's the story of the people. It's the story of how World War II impacts the people, you know, and getting the kids to realize that nothing happens overnight, getting them to realize that, you know, what happened 50 years ago still has something, might still have a relevance today. And that's, to me, very interesting when they see that connection.
Not every kid's going to succeed in history, but I think the way she teaches and the way she works, she makes it accessible to everybody.
Well, she knows how to handle kids and handle students and respect them as human beings.
She's very different from a lot of teachers. Like, she is very personal with her students, but she keeps a level of professionalism.
Very no-nonsense, but still very compassionate. So like, if a kid actually has a problem, that's fine. But if a kid just has like their headphones in or what have you, you know, she's gonna call you out on it.
Sometimes I'm sarcastic and they, you know, some kids appreciate that. Some kids, you know, don't appreciate my humor, but that's okay, because I try to appreciate theirs.
Like, she usually doesn't love, like, she doesn't like hugs or anything, but I, you know, I always hug her and stuff, and she just deals with it because it's Wiz.
Hannah was a student at Archbishop Carroll when she started at Summer Stage. And if I remember, she was very quiet, very shy.
When I was 12, my parents were like, you're gonna do Summer Stage and it's gonna be awesome. And I'm like, all right, sure. But what I can say is once I got there, I never wanted to leave.
She just gravitated towards tech, and she's been here, I think her first year was like 99 or something like that. And then, so she's been involved ever since.
I guess I was a program member for about 3 years, and then I was hired as an intern, worked as a prop master.
She and her cohort, Tim Bruno, would do props, and we'd have to throw them out of the building at midnight because they just wouldn't go home. They would just work and work and work.
And then when I got older, I got to see, I can pass this down to somebody else.
From that, she actually became the head of our tech education program. So she shepherds all the kids around who are our tech program members.
It's like almost like a teaching position in the sense that, you know, I make sure the kids are here and, you know, they're learning. But it's also showing them through a way that they can understand, like, how theater can help them. The more you get involved in school, is the better off you're going to be. The more people you're going to meet, the connections, and the better off you're going to be.
During the school year, she's the producer for our shows.
Being the producer means tying up all the ends of stuff that nobody else does.
It's really the behind the scenes of the behind the scenes, because I don't necessarily have the hands-on that I did 9 years ago when I was building the props for the shows. But I do a lot of paperwork and, you know, talk to the school, talk to the people that run the shows, and make sure the kids are on track and make sure program information's in and that kind of thing.
Working like costume designing or set designing or painting, we can't always keep an eye on all that stuff. So it's nice to have that certain person that will take care of all that.
You know, we were talking about what shows to do, how it's going to be relevant, and when The Crucible came up, I'm like, that's awesome, because the kids like the play, they buy into it. It's challenging, but it's not Shakespeare in the difficulty level as far as language is concerned.
Well, The Crucible was written by Arthur Miller, and it's kind of symbolism for McCarthyism and the Red Scare and all of that, but it's about the Salem witch trials and witches.
I think one of the coolest things about The Crucible is that it's in the English curriculum, it's in American Studies, and Hannah's real excited about that.
She works a lot on The Crucible, and she does like a lot of stuff, like things that we aren't even aware of. I know she's working very closely with marketing to make sure all the posters and stuff are developed, but she also does just a lot of behind-the-scenes stuff that honestly not a lot of people know about.
She saw a need for the kids to be really involved in their shows and working on the publicity and doing workshops and things. So she started the Theater Society.
Hannah started the Theater Society with the support of Mr. Dietzler. It's a student-run club, so she just oversees it. And they meet and they discuss different things they can do outside of what the high school offers.
We did the shows in the fall and the spring, but there wasn't really a club or anything active about theater, like, between the seasons.
We didn't have a real connecting thing between the play and the musical during the rest of the year, and kids wanted to do more than that.
So it's just kind of things to get people involved with theater that like didn't exactly shine in the shows, to kind of give them a chance to stand out in these productions.
She looks out for kids that are not the ones that are out in public, I guess, you know, really obvious kids, and nurtures them and pushes them along a little bit, and I think she really makes a difference in a very quiet way.
She really helps us out with like the Theater Society, that we have a chance to continue to do something that we love.
Basically, at the end of the day, it comes down to her helping people. That's what she wants to do.
I remember thinking in high school when I was doing a show, seeing I was in the pit and watching the kids' faces as they were watching Captain Hook, you know, terrorize the Lost Boys. You know, that was neat to see the impact, but I wanted to be more directly hands-on. I always wanted to help people. So being a teacher was the way for me to do that.
Working with students and creating something with them has kind of shown her that her students can do really extraordinary things.
It's just nice to know that we have teachers like her that care and make as much as they can in the classroom.
You have to love where you work. You know, it's a job, but it's also in the sense that you have to find something you like. You know, you have to find your place. I would never want to be somewhere else because these kids need people. They need people that'll listen. And I don't think, you know, anywhere else I could be useful like that.